Hello and welcome. Now we have to start programming in Ruby, and before we do that we need some platform where we can write our Ruby code. Now if you have Ruby installed on your system, you can write a Ruby code directly on the terminal or the command prompt, or you can also use very simple text editors like Notepad or Notepad++. However, if you use these options, it will be a little difficult for beginners because we will not be able to get any coding help or IntelliSense or all the Ruby features there. So therefore, we use some IDEs or integrated development environments for doing coding. And for Ruby, there are some IDEs available. For example, there is a IDE called RubyMine, which is specifically for Ruby, and it is a paid IDE. There is a 30 days trial available. So if you want, you can check that. And there are other free options, like there is a Visual Studio Code, which is a very good free IDE where you can do programming in Ruby and many other languages. Just in case you want to try with Visual Studio Code, you can go on my website, that is automationstepbystep.com, and here on this website you will see there is a section for Visual Studio Code, and if you go here it will take you to the YouTube playlist where you can learn how to get set up Visual Studio Code and how you can learn all the features. So this is one option. The others are, you can use Atom, Sublime Editor, you can also use Eclipse, and you can add Ruby plugins on Eclipse and then you can start your coding with Ruby. Now if you want to use any of these IDEs, you can, or if you are using any of the IDEs already, you can still continue with your Ruby programming. There is another option that you can go on your browser and you can check for some online Ruby editors and compilers and interpreters. Now, if you use any of these, then you do not have to do any setup on your system. Even if Ruby is not set up or installed on your system, you can still go to any online Ruby editor and can try your Ruby programming or do your Ruby programming there. So one of the good options that I have found is ripple.it. So if I go to Ripple Ruby, here you can go to this online editor, ripple.it, and here you can do your Ruby programming. So let me very quickly show you. If you go here, it will bring up a Ruby online editor and you can see it here. And there are a lot of other options available like Python, JS, C, C++, Java, etc. So as of now, I am on Ruby, and here you can write your Ruby program and can click on run here and it will show you the output here. Now, this is on your browser, and if you sign in or sign up here, you can get some more features. So let me show you. I will log in. You can first sign up and then sign in. I will give my username and then password and sign in. Now here, this is my account, and here is a plus button where I can select which language I want. For example, I will select Ruby, and I can give a name to the folder, or it is called create a new Ripple. Let us say I'll just give my name and I will say create Ripple, and you will see here we will have an editor. So here you can see I have got an editor. Now here we have some more features. You can see all your files and folders here. You can create new files and do all the settings and setups, and here is our location, or here is the area where we can write code, and this will show us the output. Now if you see here, we can go to settings and I can say side by side or stacked. I can use a light theme or a dark theme. I can say font size normal or large, spaces, all these options I can do. Now here you can also see some Ruby examples. Let us say I start typing here. I will say puts, and you can also see it is giving me some IntelliSense as well. So it is showing me all these options, and I will say hello world, and if I click on run now, you will see the output on this window here. So this is showing me all the outputs, and then I can create folders and files, and then there is version controlling, there is packages and database. All these options are here. So if you just want to start and try some basic Ruby, you can use this online editor, and I will show you some of the basic programming on this editor. But then if you want to create a complete project and have a complete kind of a structure or a framework, you can then use some IDE like RubyMine or Visual Studio Code. In the later sessions, I will show you Visual Studio Code, but to start with the basic programming, we can use this online editor. So I hope we will have lots of fun learning Ruby together. So let's get started, and I will see you in the next session. Thank you for watching.